pop the pain away. I slide the pain away. I pop the pain away. I slide the pain away.
So this is my hostel room for Naples, and naturally, I am on the third story of a triple-decker bunk bed. I only say that because I've been on the top bunk bed all but once throughout my trip.
I made it to Naples and I parted ways with my parents, so again, I am traveling solo. First overall impression is that the transportation infrastructure seems to favor cars rather than walking. It's a lot more sus to walk on these streets and doesn't seem quite as accessible by foot as some of the other European cities that I've visited. I dropped my bag off early this afternoon in the hostel, and I was just aimlessly walking down the shore path, but I found a castle, and I'm gonna see how much it costs to go in. It was closed, so I'm not going inside. Naples is much bigger than I realized. That's a cafe over there. So it's about 60 degrees outside, but with the sun hitting me, it honestly feels incredible. It feels a lot warmer than 60, a good change of pace. So for reference, that over there is Pompeii and Mount Vesuvius in the background. And then over there is Sorrento, where we stayed for two nights. And then on the other side of that is Amalfi and the Amalfi Coast, where we also stayed for two nights. My lunch was €3. I got a slice of pizza for €2 and this water bottle for one. Feeling very indecisive about getting this bag. I think I'm gonna get it. It's only €16 and I'll be way cooler if I have this. Okay, we'll say the drip is a work in progress. Not as cool as Europeans yet, but I don't know. I'm getting there. So I just walked 40 minutes to the National Archaeological Museum of Naples, and come to find out, it is closed on Tuesdays. Now I gotta find out something else to do. So allegedly Naples has a system of underground corridors, so I'm gonna go check that out and see what it's all about.
Too late to set my demons straight. I know I made you wait. How much
exactly? This pizza is €6.
All right.
This is my first time drinking with Mexicans, right?
Yeah. Excelente, excelente.
Anybody can be in it. I'm just taking a vlog.
Yeah, you can show that to me, because I've been doing that the whole trip.
All right.
Twice, remember?
Yep, twice. Double the
luck. You came straight from Germany?
Yeah.
Naples, night one. We're having a good time.
Excelente.
All right, so we just met at the hostel, and it turns out that we both went to the University of Illinois in Champaign.
Yeah.
And we lived in the same building.
Right
off of Green Street and Smile.
Yeah, it's insane.
It really is insane. It was really cool.
Mm-hmm. Greetings to Chicago.
Mamma mia, here I go again. My, how can I resist you? Mamma mia, does it show again? My,
just how much I miss you. Na, 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 na.
So I drank way too much last night, as evidenced by the previous videos. We started drinking in the hostel and we were doing karaoke. And then there was a group of us that ended up going out, and we were out until about 3. I ended up waking up at 7 or so. So I didn't get too much sleep, and I'm kind of paying the price of that today. I'm really tired. I just got some strawberries for 2 euros and they're really good. And I'm about to go hike up to the Castel St. Elmo, I think. I probably butchered that name, but I was initially gonna go to the archaeological museum, but I decided against it because it was 22 euros and I thought it was gonna be 2 euros.
I wonder where I lost my way. Been waiting on your call all day.
If you had to guess if I had my drone on me or not right now, what would you say? Go ahead, guess. Alright, well, I do. That'd be kind of stupid if I didn't. This bag's actually a lot bigger than you expect it to be. Okay. I'm gonna try flying my drone and see how it turns out.
Tell me you in my corner right now. When I fall short, I'm leaning on you to cry out. We all got enough to lie about. My truth too complicated to hide now. Can I open up? Is it safe or not? I'm afraid a little you relate or not. Have faith a little, I might take my time. Ain't no saving face this time.
I hope I'm not too late to set my demons straight.
So it was 5 euros to get into the castle grounds, and I'm assuming that that also covers entrance into the actual castle. So the answer is yes, it is free to come inside. Or not free, but included in the 5 euro price.
Check out this view though.
I got some regrets, but my past won't keep me from my best. Subtle mistakes felt like life or death. I wanna see the family stronger. I wanna see the money longer. You know that I'd die for you. I get emotional about life. The lost ones keeping me up.
I love traveling solo because I can decide if I wanna stay and look at the view for 2 hours. I absolutely can. But real talk though, I do need some food. It is such a beautiful day today. It's about 65 degrees, and I'm just feeling extra appreciative of the fact that I'm standing here right now. It's so cool. Overall though, Castel St. Elmo is 100% worth the 5 euros. I legitimately spent 2 hours here, so I really liked it. If you come to Naples, I highly recommend checking this out. Naples is known as the Italian city where there's lots of petty theft and small crimes like pickpocketing, but personally I felt quite safe in Naples thus far. There have only been really one or two instances where I just stereotyped certain people and was a little bit nervous, but outside of that I felt quite safe. However, if I was a woman or even a smaller man, I think I would probably have a much different experience. I think in general, I come off as pretty intimidating, as I'm generally a bit bigger than most European men. So do with that as you will, but still, I would not walk around solo in the middle of the night. I'm still taking those precautionary measures to be safe, but in general, I feel that Naples is a pretty safe city.
Pray for London, yeah. I want it all without you involved. I guess it's all for nothing.
Thank you.
So a week before I left for my trip, my average resting heart rate was 62 beats per minute. And this last week, my average resting heart rate has been 53 beats per minute. And for those of you that don't know, resting heart rate is a pretty good metric to describe what your cardiovascular fitness level looks like. But it's also a good metric to help understand what sorts of stress levels you've been under. And for me personally, the last 2 weeks, I have been doing a bit more fitness, just walking, but my resting heart rate has dropped quite significantly. And I don't think that it's only attributable to that increase in activity. Because when I am at home, I do a lot more intense workouts. So I would have figured that if anything, my average resting heart rate might have gone up a little bit. Obviously, I'm not a cardiologist, so these are just my assumptions. But I think the main reason for this significant drop in my resting heart rate can be attributed to the focus that I've put on becoming more zen. I've put more and more focus on maintaining a sense of calm in seemingly intense situations. I think for this whole trip, I've had quite a few more high stress type situations. And I'm trying to change how I react in those situations. I've come to the realization that sometimes I can't control what the situation is, but I can control how I react to said situation. And I can control my mindset and my breathing and how calm I can be in a situation. I've sort of had this paradigm shift that in every tricky type situation, for instance, I'm coming down a mountain and there are cliffs and there's a huge drop, and my parents definitely had a difficult time getting down that mountain, and honestly I was quite scared, but rather than freak out, I couldn't control the fact that I was in that situation, but I could just maintain a sense of calm in that situation and help my parents get down the mountain and make sure that we all got down safely. In the book Atomic Habits, he talks about how you should have identity-based habits and habits that can be traced back to who you are as a person. I've been trying to switch my identity from this very over-the-top type A personality to someone that has a lot more calmness on a day-to-day basis. And every time that I make a decision to react calmly or to take a deep breath and evaluate what the situation actually is rather than emotionally react to the situation, I cast a vote for being that type of person, being a type of person that has that level of calm in their life. And obviously, this is a slow process. It's not going to switch overnight. But I think this health metric of my resting heart rate dropping as significantly as it has is a good indicator that I'm headed in the right direction. I'm really excited to continue in this growth trajectory towards being more calm with having no idea what I'm doing. As I've mentioned previously, this trip is really far outside of my comfort zone, and there is a lot of ambiguity on a day-to-day basis. But I think that through that ambiguity and getting out of my comfort zone, I think I'm getting daily practice, and it's enabling me to be more calm in situations where I'm just sitting on the coast of Naples and looking around, you know? Like, it's that juxtaposition and that difference of high-stress situations and breathing through those, and then you can get to situations where you're a lot more calm when you go through everything throughout a day. And that's something that I've really always enjoyed about practicing yoga, because sometimes it's going to be really hard, and it's really hard to breathe, but if you can maintain that breath and find that sense of calmness, you can get through really challenging things, and then that makes the reward of chilling out or just sitting and enjoying life so much more rewarding. I think that's going to conclude the Naples video. I hope you enjoyed watching. If you did enjoy this video, please consider subscribing. It helps me out. I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. I'm hoping to eventually be able to monetize my content, and I need to get to that threshold to be able to do so. But yeah, thank you so much for all of the support so far, and thank you for 400 subscribers. That's really cool. So, peace out.